One of the nice things about woodworking is you can make things that you want. And my daughter Tara, who's 14, asked me to make a box, a little trinket box for her. So, I glued a couple boards together. If you look close, you can see some seams. I put two pieces of walnut, they're 1/8 inch. Then there's 1, 2, 3 pieces of birch. And then you can even see the seam at the seam when I cut the box. There's 2 more pieces of 1/8 walnut. So I glued those all together. It started out as a square. And then I cut it out of my router. And then I have a tiny little axis right there. Came in with the bandsaw, zooped around. And then I took this off. I sliced it there. Sliced it there. So I can then make the box. Hollowed the box out. And I sanded the crap out of it. And I glued this back together. Do the same. I put the back back on the back. And I cut that off to get the hole out, center out the core. And I put a little bit of teak oil on it. And it's a cool little box. And you can make these any shape. My next one. My next one will be tall, horizontal, multiple drawer. I think I'm gonna do a 2-drawer. So I'm gonna come up with the kind of a funky angle and have the drawers that way. So you can do a lot of different things with them. There's, the sky's the limit, your imagination, you can't skew them up. I just kind of freehanded that because, you know, now that I'm done, I kind of came a little wide here. My bottom's a little scooped there. But in a way, it makes it look nice. It's obviously handmade. But it came up pretty cool. I had fun doing it. That was actually a very easy project. The hardest part was the sanding. It took a lot of sanding to get that smoothed down. The bandsaw uses a lot of, or leaves a lot of marks, saw marks. So I'm going to swap out my blade next week. I've ordered a new blade that's supposed to be a lot smoother. And I'll play with the tension a little bit and make a few more. I'll update YouTube when I do. Bye.